Who's ready to share out? Yes. Nice. From right there? Yeah. All right, what are we thinking? Thank you, Michelle, for that hand, Denaja, Samaj, Oshalemi. You're doing pretty well. I need a couple more hands. Some of us are writing. I'll give you a few more seconds to get down your ideas. Yes. What do you have for us? The way his body started sweating in fear. How does that show desperation? Swept forward. You just said trench. Go ahead, Oshalemi.
I want to build on that because it is just repetition. So basically, like, basically to exaggerate that how he felt and on the inside, and it was like basically trying to say that he wanted to he wanted to panic because. It was believable, but then he had to keep himself together for his child, and then, yeah.
What was being repeated?
No way.
No way, right? Jazz, can you share out what we discussed in the back? Because Oshimani's sitting on this idea of panic.
He was very in denial for the last section because it shows, like, when he was talking to his daughter, when his daughter told, or whatever the person, he said, no, you're lying, the Rockets will come back. He was very in denial because he wasn't thinking reality. He was just worried and and all that fear that was built up over time shows how he was very desperate.
Nice. Michelle?
Yeah, when he repeated no way, he was building panic and it was putting stress on all of his family about not being able to go back to Earth.
Can you say that last piece again?
It was building on like stress on his family about not being able to go back to Earth.
Nice. All these words. Stress. You guys did a really great job with this. I love that I saw so many of you pinpointing all that key diction in the text. Why is it important to pinpoint the key diction as we're reading a text and trying to unpack that? Shiloh.
So that it could describe it could help describe how the mood connects the text.
Say that again?
It could help describe how the mood supports the part of the text.
Okay.
Samaj?
I want you to get a better understanding about what the author wants you to see.
Say that loud and proud.
I said it helps you get a better understanding of the text and how the author wants you to see the mood in the tone.
How the author's feeling? Jazz?
And so you have a deeper meaning of it. Other people have different perspective on different things.
Right, so attack that deeper meaning. We've been working a lot with like zooming in and zooming out. Remember, it's not just with writing, it's everything, right? You read a text, you zoom in on key diction, you think about what connections you make, you bring it out to think about what's the deeper message in this section. For today, it's like the deeper message of the mood. It could just be the deeper message overall or specific to what we're focusing on. The same thing you do when you're reading is the same thing we do with writing. So that's why we keep practicing it, so we can keep getting better, because remember, we want to get prepared for what you're going to see next year in high school and beyond. You got to keep pushing that and making sure that you're building those independent habits, all right? So now we're going to continue reading together this section. And the reason why we're reading some parts together is just to kind of like get through as much as possible and making sure that we're having those specific moments where we're practicing.